I'm Jos and I'm gameplay developer at Giants. I'll tell you something about the seasonal cycles in Farming Simulator 22. The seasonal cycles in Farming Simulator 22 bring a whole new level of gameplay. First, we have spring. In spring, the trees have vibrant colors and the brand new year starts. Then we have summer, where the plants mature and the trees darken. Afterwards, we get autumn with its dark undercolors and red and brown trees, depending on the tree type. And in the end, we have winter, where all the leaves fall from the trees and you get snow. A year is divided into 12 months. Every month is one day in the game. But you can still control how fast the day passes. This way, season can range from half an hour of game time up to a whole weekend. The biggest change in gameplay that comes with the seasonal cycles is the new crop calendar. The crop calendar decides whether you can plant barley or must stay with cotton. For example, the barley is a winter barley in our game, so you can only plant it in the autumn and it will grow until ripe summer. This way, throughout the year, you have to decide whether you can plant something or you cannot. This adds a whole new level of gameplay and mechanics to the crop system. But there is more. Because of the varying times of harvest for each crop, you also get varying prices during the year. This way, it is not the best method to sell directly after harvesting. You should store your product and sell it the year after to get better prices. In the winter, we have snow, which you can remove with the snowplows to keep your yard clean. Also, grass does not grow in the winter, so if you have animals, you have to make sure you get enough food for them before the winter starts. If you don't like removing snow in the winter, or you don't have animals, you can choose to skip a whole day ahead, or even more than one day, to keep the pace to your game. There have been a lot of challenges in implementing this feature into the base game. We knew from the Seasons mod that this feature would be very popular, but a lot of people, they prefer freedom of planting whenever or harvesting whenever they want. That's why we wanted to find a middle ground that worked for every player in a wide player base. We also made changes to the game engine to add better performance to our new growth system. Adding toggles to our game adds complexity due to the possible scenarios that we have to test and balance. We also added new changes to our game engine to add more performant growth and more reliable growth. We also updated our maps to take full advantage of the new changes with the seasons. We added snowmen, we added snow on roofs, and we added many items that depend on the current season. We hope you have fun with our new snowmen. Mod makers can also adjust their mods to the new system. Map makers, for example, can add objects to the game that are only visible in the summer, for example, a barbecue. They can also define exactly where snow falls and does not fall, and when the lights turn on and off. With the new environment tab in the editor, it is also possible to change the light intensity based on the season. With the new environment tab, it is also possible to control when objects are visible and are not visible, much easier than before. On top of all this, map makers can define where their map is located in the world. They can do this by adjusting the location in the world and adding a new weather and crop calendar. This way, you can define that in the south of the world, your sugarcane grows much faster than in the north. It is also possible to add new integrations into the seasonal cycles for your mods. And we hope to see a lot of new gameplay features being added based on the time of the year. I'm interested to hear what you think about these new features. And if you have questions, you can ask them in the upcoming Q&A. Back to FarmCon.